mentioned, and one of the things when the patients come into your office and they are diagnosed with HPV, you mentioned there are many strains. Some strains are more different than others. Can you talk a little bit about the strains? How many are there?
Well, there is multiple strains, and there's a numerous amount of high, but there's four that are mainly identified. Okay. 6 and 11, 16 and 18 are the most common ones. 6 and 11 are benign, and 16 and 18 are more of a malignant. But within those, there's a lot of others that are definitely associated with high-risk lesions, and they're multiple and not identified. The reason why these are more known is because of the vaccine that was developed specifically for those four strains of HPVs.
The HPV vaccine, correct?
The HPV vaccine.
Now, does it go away on its own, or can the vaccine help prevent it? And if you already have it, what happens?
Well, the HPV in general, it could, your body immune system, in the majority of the cases, especially the younger population, tends to eliminate it without problems. But vaccine does protect from you to developing those strains, and it protects against those four that I mentioned earlier. And definitely the vaccine is a preventive, is what it is. It causes immunization to your body.
So in general, it does not go on, does it not go away on its own?
Well, it does. At least your immune system should be able to not eliminate, but at least we're not able to detect it. Now, whether or not years later this HPV vaccine comes back, or whether or not we're just not able to detect it at certain times, mm-hmm. is something that we're still investigating.